lady. Gracious gentlemen, a servant begs your pardon for your time, but there is much to tell. Tom Rakeful had an uncle, one long parted from his native land. Him I served many years, served him in the many trades he served in turn, and all to his profit. Yes, profit was perpetually his. It was indeed his family, his friend, his power of amusement, his wife. But all his brilliant progeny of gold could not caress him when he lay dying, sick for his home, sick for a memory of pleasure or of love. His thoughts were but of England. There, at least he felt, his profit could be pleasure to an eager youth. For such, by counting years upon his fumbling fingers, he knew that you must be good, sir. Well, he is dead. And I am here with this commission to tell Tom Rakewell that an unloved and forgotten uncle, loved and remembered, you are a rich man. Come, master, observe the host of mankind. How are they wretched? Why? Because they are not free. Why? Because the giddy multitude are driven by the unpredictable lust of their pleasures, and the sober few are bound by the inflexible oath of their duty, between which slaveries nothing to choose. Would you be happy? Then learn to act freely. Would you act freely? Then learn to ignore those twin tyrants of appetite and conscience. Therefore, I counsel you, master, take Baba the Turk to wife. Consider her picture once more, and as you do so, reflect upon my words. In youth, the panting slave pursues the fair evasive dame. Then caught in colder fetters, wounds, wealth, office, or a name, till old, dishonored, sick, downcast, and failing in his wits, in virtue's narrow cell at last, the withered bondsman sits. His fate fulfills. For he alone is free, who chooses what to will, and wills his choice as destiny. No eye his future can foretell, no law must explain, whom either passion may compel, nor